All right, so I am back on live for Victoria's, so we invite her, then I'll invite her. Oh, she joined, yay, all right. Oop. So I'm gonna have her join, and yeah.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing pretty well.
So thank you so much for doing the takeover today. It's so much fun, and you will continue to do it the rest of the day, of course.
Yes. It was so much fun. Thank you for letting me do it. That was actually my first takeover, and I just had a blast. It was so much fun.
Yeah. I mean, it was so much fun for me, too, for everyone, hopefully, because I love doing these takeovers and watching them because I get to learn so much about everyone, and it's a lot of fun because you can answer some questions. So I always like to start these lives a little earlier, like 6:56 or whatever it is, like 40 minutes early. I used to do 5, but then I decided to do 4. It's fine, don't worry. I actually didn't even get your request.
Kayla.
Probably because Victoria's on with me. Yeah, it's totally fine. Don't worry about it. What I was saying was I normally like to start a little early so people can join. Make sure to watch Victoria's takeover. It's really awesome. She answers lots of questions, and if you have any more questions, you can always put them in the takeover, or if you want to answer now, that's fine too.
I'm probably, after this, I'm probably going to put another little question box, because I've just done so many stories, they probably got lost in there, so I'll definitely add another one for anyone who wants to ask something afterwards, or, yeah.
Yeah.
So, if you ever, like, want to message me, like, after today, you can reach me at my personal Instagram because I won't have access to the JDRF Instagram past day. So, yeah, I just wanted to let people know because I noticed someone, I think, was trying to message me but accidentally messaged through the JDRF. So I just wanted to make that clear.
Yeah. I will definitely put Victoria's, you know, username so everyone can go follow her and message her if you want to message her. And if anyone's trying to message you, Victoria, and you know they're trying to message you, you can always answer them. It's totally
fine. I was I saw my friend, and she was like, I think she was responding to one of my stories, and I was like, should I open this or not? I didn't just be safe, but yeah, maybe I'll do that afterwards.
Yeah, it's totally fine. I normally just say, like, don't open DMs if it's for me, obviously. But if you know it's there for you, and if it's your friend or something, you could totally fine. You can open it.
Yeah, I really appreciate all the work you, because it must seem crazy to, like, you know, you probably feel like change the password and, like, do all these different things to make sure, like, wow, that's just a lot of work. Because I actually, it's not a cabaret, but I do, you've probably seen it, but I do my little, like, artist alive thing where I, like, guest other actors and stuff. And I actually have thought of doing takeovers, but maybe I'll try it one day. But it's definitely a lot of work, so I definitely commend you for that.
Thank you. It's actually not as hard as it looks. I actually thought that you couldn't change your password after a certain amount of time. But you can actually just go in and, you know, if you remember your old password, you can just change it right there. So, at first I was very, you know, worried to do takeovers.
Yeah.
Like, you know, I don't know if I'm gonna, like, how to change the password every time, or, like, if I should just use my own password. I'm not giving out my own normal password, like that. So, but I figured it out. I talked to some people. They helped me.
Well, if I ever decide to do it, I'll definitely come to you for tips.
Yeah, you can totally come to me. I can help you out if you ever need any help. If anyone needs help, if anyone wants to do Instagram takeovers, if anyone wants to do cabarets, if anyone, you can always come to me. I love helping people. I'm always available. Quarantine, you have nothing to do. Of course. I can help you. Let's I like to see. So it's like very confusing because like in the top corner, like right there, it's only one person on. Sorry, that's my dog. I don't know if you can hear that, but it says a lot of people join, so I'm not sure who's on or not. We will find out though. Soon enough. Because people will find out. Hopefully it will reload and be like, if there is one person, that's totally fine. I don't care.
Yeah.
I'm just saying it because there's a lot of people that joined. That's the only reason I'm saying it. But yeah, since you did the takeover, I'm not going to do a full-on interview so people can continue to ask you questions. But if anyone has any questions that you want to ask now, obviously save some questions for her takeover. But if there's anything you want to ask her now, if you're okay with that, or if anyone has any questions for me. If not, we can just talk for a little bit and then you can
perform. Yeah.
So, I saw your bunnies, by the way, and I was like, those are the most adorable things ever.
Aww.
I hold them.
I love them so much. Yeah, I know. I was like, it can't be an Instagram takeover without showing my bunnies because they are such a big part of my life. So I was like, well, if I'm gonna, you know, give a glimpse into my life, I guess I have to show my bunnies. And they were so cute. And especially when I was filming them, they were being extra adorable. So it just all worked out.
Yeah, I love animals so much. Bunnies used to be my favorite animal. And I wanted one for so long. I still want one, of course. Because they're the sweetest. My sister has a guinea pig. And of course, I have dogs. I really want a bunny because they're like in between a dog and a guinea pig.
Exactly. No, we call our bunnies forever puppies because they're like, they stay small forever. And they're just like, they're sometimes so playful and they're just so cute. So, yeah.
I love bunnies and rabbits and
the
same thing, but bunnies are babies, I'm assuming.
Yeah, different. I just like, even though my one bunny, Snickers, is 7 years old, we still call him a baby because he's so small.
Yeah, same. I call all my dogs babies. one of my dog that was barking, her name is Shadow. She's 11.
Wow.
And I call her baby. She's my baby. And she's a big baby, but.
What kind of dog?
Sorry, what?
What kind of dog is she?
So Shadow, we don't know because we rescued her and they never really, know. But my other two dogs, I have a French Bulldog mix, and then I have a Lab Dachshund mix.
Oh.
Yeah, so my Lab Dachshund mix and my French Bulldog are at my mom's house, and I'm currently at my dad's house. So I only have one dog here, and that's Shadow. And my other dogs, Molly and Sam, are my mom.
I used to have dogs when I was younger. They unfortunately passed away, but I had a Cocker Spaniel named Kayla, and she lived till she was like 17 or 18, I believe. And then I also had a Lab named Tucker.
Aw, that's amazing, though, that your dog that lived till 17 or 18.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Yeah, she was like, was with my mom since her 20s. So like she was my mom's dog. And then when we were born, when my mom was like 27, I believe, she was still with the family. So it's kind of cool that my mom had her for that long and then got to bring her into the family.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
My grandma had a dog and her name was Shayna. I don't know if she had her before. She did have her before I was born. She had a dog named Max and she had a dog named Shayna. Max passed away sadly when he was, I don't know how old he was. But Shayna lived till 17 or 16, and, so she was a little Yorkie, the sweetest thing. I always say that she was, like, my first dog, because even though she was my grandma's, my grandma lives pretty close, so we would go there all the time, and Shayna was, like, my first dog.
Aww.
So, yeah, and it was amazing she lived so long.
That's awesome, yeah. My dad especially, he lived on a farm when he was younger, and he had so many different, like, types of pets. Like, one time he had a pig that lived in the house, like a full-size pig, not like a teacup pig, but a full-size. And they've had so many different animals. Like, he had a ferret. He just, like, so many different animals that you could imagine. I'm pretty sure he had ducks that were living in the house at some point. But, yeah, crazy.
My mom's favorite animal besides dogs, obviously, is pigs. She loves them. Definitely want one if she could have one in the house. But
yeah, my grandma was really, really obsessed with pigs. Unfortunately, she passed away a few years ago. But she was one of those people that she collected all those little trinkets. So she would have these little pig statues, like, around the house, like, little mini figurines and stuff. And, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know how well my dogs would interact with the pig. but, I mean, we always say my French bulldog, Molly, we call her a pig. Because she snorts and...
Oh, my gosh. That's so
very weird. We say she has a bunch of animals in her. She's half pig, she's half cow, she's half dog. She's just a very weird dog. So she's the closest we're gonna get to a pig, I think.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. I think I was just thinking, because you know how, like, humans, we, like, a question that we ask is like, oh, what's your spirit animal? Maybe animals have spirit animals too.
Yeah. Think so.
I have spirit animals of other animals, so they have a little bit of another animal inside them.
Yeah, I definitely think my dog Molly's spirit animal is a pig. I wonder if, like, your rabbits probably have spirit animals too. I think everyone has a spirit animal.
Yeah. I don't know. They're just like I said, they're almost like little puppies. I don't know. They're just like, you know how puppies, like, they are so playful, but then at the end of the night, like, once they're done, they're, like, out. Like, they're so tired. That's, like, how my bunnies are. They'll be, like, half the time they'll be so crazy, and they'll be, like, running around. And my one, like, younger bunny, Willow, she, like, does these little crazy jumps where she'll flip her ears. To, like, twist around. But yeah, they're like, they do kind of the same thing. Like, I'll come down and she'll be like so crazy, and she'll, like, come to the edge of the cage, and then sometimes when I come down, she'll literally just be, like, flopped over, and, like, she won't even come out. She'll just, like, ignore me. She's like, nope. It's
that's so cute. Oh my god. And all the time we say that my dog Sam, he's like a cat, because he's like a black cat. Because he loves to be outside, and cats love to be outside all the time. But he also he's a hunter. But he has the sweetest heart. Like, he'll never hurt, he'll never hurt a human. Mm-hmm. But he'll go outside in the backyard and kill a bird in 3 seconds.
Oh my god. It's like they're so sweet. They're so sweet to you. And then it's just like, but they still, you know, you gotta remember, they still have their, like, survival instincts. And even... Yeah. See that with rabbits, because obviously they know they're safe, but rabbits are prey animals, so, like, in the wild, they would be, like, you know, always alert and, like, making sure that they don't get eaten. So, like, rabbits, too, like, sometimes it takes a while to gain their trust, because they'll be, you know, easily scared. They get easily scared by, like, loud noises, or, like, you know, when you're walking around them, because you're so giant compared to them. But, yeah, we've gotten really lucky. All of our bunnies have been really trusting of us. And actually... one point we had 8 bunnies.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah. It was just crazy because we went on, like, a bunny craze. We had our first bunny was named Riley, and then we got another bunny named Ginger, and I think we got a few other bunnies the same time we got Ginger. And then Riley and Ginger had babies, and so they had babies once, and the first time they had one bunny named Thumper, and then they had another litter of babies, and they had 4 bunnies, and Snickers was one of the 4 babies, and the rest of them either passed away, unfortunately, or we sold them to, like, family friends and stuff. So yeah,
can't imagine a baby bunny.
They're so cute, and, like, to watch them, like, grow up, they're just so fluffy, and it's the best.
Oh, that's so adorable. I would love to have a baby bunny and then watch it grow up too. I'm definitely gonna have a bunny when I'm older.
Yeah, they grow up so quickly, it's, like, crazy. Like, we got Willow, when did we get her? We got her in November of last year, and she grew up so fast. Like, she's already bigger than my other bunny, 7 years old. Like, she's already bigger than him, and she's, like, 5 months now. She's going to be 6 months soon, but, yeah, it's kind of crazy.
That's so adorable. My sister's guinea pig. It's my sister's guinea pig still. It's not really mine, but I mean, if she heard me say it was mine, she'd get very mad. He was tiny when we first got him. And now he's like 3 pounds, probably because we feed him too much. But he's a very big guinea pig. He's adorable.
Oh my gosh. Nicole, you didn't miss it. You're good. I haven't done my little performance thing yet. We've just been talking about animals the whole time, so.
Yes, animals. Yes. And I do know Nicole. We did society performers together. So.
Nicole also does actor site. I know we did the improv together, but yeah, Nicole also did, Nicole did a class with me and with Miss Kimberly.
Yes, animals are amazing. And yeah, so Victoria and I also did an after site class together with
Ben.
With Ben. Yeah, I was reading the chat in the middle of the sentence. Hi, Nicole. I was reading the chat and I was like, with, and then I stopped for a second. I know it was Ben. I was just in the middle of reading the thing because I'm weird. But anyway, so yeah, in the beginning of the year, I did Society Performers, which is an acting, like kind of like actor site. Ben was one of the teachers. Amber was one of the teachers.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure who else. Yeah, so we did that together in the beginning of the year. 2020, not this year, 2020, kind of when the quarantine started.
Yeah.
And then I stopped because I did some other things. And then we kind of reconnected, me and Victoria, connected through actor site, and then Victoria knows Nicole, so it's like a big triangle.
I honestly love, like, I've met so many awesome, like, some of my closest, like, actor friends that I, like, know online are from classes, and I really love meeting people in classes and stuff like that.
Yeah, it was definitely so much fun when we did the class together.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun.
Yeah, and Ben is awesome.
Yes, acting friends are the best, and I am, like, so I'm 17, so I'm going to be 18 this year. So I can still get into some of, like, the teen classes, but soon I'll be moving up into the adult classes. So I'll be, you know, doing fancy adult things. I don't know what that's going to look like. But I feel like I'm going to miss, like, doing all the kid and teen stuff because it's so much fun. Now I'll actually have to be serious.
That's crazy. It's, like, crazy. Like, I'm 15. I'm almost 16. Not almost 16, but in August I'll be 16. My mom is like, oh my god, what the heck, you're like growing up so quick. Of course every mom is like that, but like yeah, so
crazy.
Yeah, I mean, I don't feel like I'm 15, I still feel like I'm 10.
Honestly, yeah. You don't have to be serious. Yeah, I know. I'm still gonna hopefully do improv classes and be able to do fun things. But it's just like, when I hear about all these like adult like acting things, it's like adults do so intense like training sometimes. So I'm like, I think that's exciting, like to be able to like do that kind of like serious stuff, because when you're 18, like there's so many different roles that open up. So that's gonna be really exciting. But yeah. Nicole, you're so active. Why don't you ask us some questions? No, Nicole actually already asked so many questions. Nicole's been awesome.
Thank you.
Oh, my Nana joined. Hi, Nana. I love you.
Aw. Hi. Hi, Victoria's Nana. Welcome. She will be singing soon, so.
Yes.
Actually, you can sing right now if you want.
I could, and then we could maybe talk the rest of the time just to...
So I'm going to step out. I always do that. So okay. People aren't focusing on me. So yeah.
Awesome. Okay. So I'm going to be singing On My Own from Les Mis. On my own, pretending he's beside me, all alone. I walk with him till morning. Without him, I feel his arms around me. And when I lose my way, I close my eyes and he's found me. In the rain, the pavement shines like silver. All the lights are misty in the river. In the darkness, the trees are full of starlight. And all I see is him and me forever and forever. And I know it's only in my mind that I'm talking to myself and not to him. And although I know that he is blind, still I say, there's a way for us. I love him, but when the night is over, he is gone. The river's just a river. Without him, the world around me changes. The trees are bare and everywhere, the streets are full of strangers. I love him, but every day I'm learning. All my life, I've only been pretending. Without me, his world will go on turning. A world that's full of happiness that I have never known. I love him. I love him. I love him. But only on my own.
Yay, that was so amazing. I love that song so much.
Oh my gosh, everyone is so sweet. I need to look at the comments now because I didn't get to see them.
And I wanted to say I'm so sorry if you could hear my dog. I was like cringing out there. I was like, shush. I'm so sorry about that. There's no mute button on the Instagram Live. If there was, of course, I would mute it. But besides my dog, she wanted a little solo. You were so, so amazing. I love that song.
Thank you. Yeah, that's one of my faves. I love that one.
I love that show. It's definitely a family favorite.
Mm-hmm. I really like the movie too. I thought they did a good job of like adapting it into the movie, and I love Hugh Jackman and Amanda Seyfried, and there's some awesome actors in the movie. Nicole, you're the sweetest. Like, oh, I love you so much.
Oh my god. I love support here. Thank you so much to everyone who support. It was amazing. So
oh,
you deserve all of it.
Said, hi Victoria, I'm 17. My birthday is August 16th. Oh, that's so awesome. I guess it seems like you're turning 18 this year. Well, my birthday is July 22nd, so we have very close birthdays.
Summer birthdays.
Yes.
In August, too. August 24th. So, yeah, we're all summer birthdays, not all. She agrees.
I love my family and friends. I can't. They're so sweet.
Yes. Support from family and friends.
For you.
Thank you, everyone. Of course, you deserve what everyone is saying, because you were amazing, and they're not wrong.
But
song is amazing.
Someone said, I'm an April baby, odd one out. I have a quick question. Are you Vicky or Tori, like, nickname-wise? I actually haven't really ever gone by, like, a nickname. I know some people with the name Victoria, like, only go by their nickname. But I like, friends call me sometimes. I've had friends call me Toria, like, just without the Vic, so just Toria. Or I've had friends call me, like, Vivi or Vicky, yeah. But, yeah, so I don't usually go by, like, an official nickname. But, yeah, I have people that call me nicknames sometimes.
It's not a weird question, Nicole.
It's not a weird question. Honestly, you're keeping it interesting, Nicole. You are powering this live right now.
Great. And Carly is the weirdest name, too, for nicknames, at least.
Yeah.
Because nobody goes, like, when their name is Carly, they might go by, like, Carl or Car.
Carly. I don't know.
I feel like a couple years ago, I was like, wait a second. I can go by Lee. Like, I've never thought about that until, like, last year.
Yeah, Nicole. I'm thinking, Nicole, you could go by Nikki. Nicole's just part of this live I wish we could just, like, add her on, but.
Yeah. I know, that would be so much fun. I don't think I can. I don't think I can. If I could, I would definitely do it, but. I'm definitely a car. Yes, oh my god, my friends used to, like, joke around and be like, car, vroom, vroom, or car, vroom, vroom. They would call me that. I have some weird friends. They don't do that anymore, but, yeah.
I think it's so funny because, like, both of our names have, like, male versions. Like, yours is Carl, Carly Carl. Actually, fun fact, that made me think, we had a bunny once that we thought was a girl, but when we found it, and we named it Carly, and then when we found out it was a boy, it became Carl.
That's actually something that my mom did. She wanted to make, I don't know why she did this. I mean, I don't, not like it, I'm just saying. So my name, it could be Carl or Carly. My sister, her name is Hallie. And she goes, sometimes my mom calls her Hal, which is a boy name. And my brother, Noah. So that's what she wanted to do. Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Nana, go sing another song, please.
I mean, if you want to, you can. But
I mean, what other songs do I know? What's a go-to? Oh, I could do She Used to Be Mine. That's one of my go-tos.
Okay, I'll step out again.
Okay.
We need another song from you.
I do. You.
All right, I'll be over here again.
Okay, let me just search it up. I'm probably only going to do the first, maybe the first two verses and chorus.
Okay.
Let me define this. Okay. Not simple to say that most days I don't recognize me. These shoes and this apron that plays and its patrons have taken more than I gave them. It's not easy to know I'm not anything like I used to be, although it's true, I was never attention's sweet center. I still remember that girl. She's imperfect, but she tries. She is good, but she lies. She is hard on herself. She is broken but won't ask for help. She is messy but she's kind. She is lonely most of the time. She is all this mixed up and baked in a beautiful pie. She is gone, but she used to be mine. And it's not what I asked for. Sometimes life slips in through the back door and carves out a person that makes you believe it's all true. Now I've got you. You're not what I asked for. If I'm honest, I know I would give it all back for a chance to start over and rewrite an ending or two for that girl that I knew, who was reckless just enough, who gets hurt but who learns how to toughen up, whom she's bruised and gets used by a man who can't and then she'll get stuck and be scared of the life that's inside her, getting stronger each day till it finally reminds her to fight just a little to bring back the fire in her eyes that's been gone, but it used to be she's kind. She is lonely most of the time. She is all this mixed up and baked in a beautiful pie. She is gone, but she used to be mine.
Yay, I love that song so much, too.
Halfway through, I realized, I was like, wait, I'm pretty much gone too far. I can't, like, stop now. So I was like, I have to finish.
No, it was amazing. I was glad you kept going. And yeah, that was amazing.
Yeah, that one, because I hadn't, I've been practicing the other one, so that one was a little bit rough, but it's okay.
Your voice is really beautiful. I wish I had that, you know, high range voice, but
yeah, it's just the main thing for me is like breathing. I have to like find places to breathe and not make it awkward, so I have to be like
yeah, I totally get that. Yeah, I've been singing forever, I totally get that.
Yeah, but Nana, that was for you.
That was dedicated to Nana. The first song was dedicated to this cabaret, the second one was dedicated to Victoria's Nana. So, very special. You were, I love Nana's, grandma's. So, just blessings. So, yeah, it's very special. And she applauded you, so.
Oh, I love her. I know my is adorable. Yes, she is. I haven't seen her in a little bit, and I miss her.
I know. COVID annoying. So, I haven't been able to see my grandma, and she lives, you know, down the street from me. Because it's dangerous. You don't want to get them sick. They're, you know, older. Lower immune system. So you don't want to get them sick.
Yep.
Of course. So it is 7:30. But thank you so much for joining me. And thank you to everyone who joined. And if you want to donate, the link is in my bio. In this account. And also my normal account, and we will end it off with how are you doing. We'll answer that question and then we'll just end it off. So I'm doing great. So how are you doing?
Such a nice question. Yeah, I'm doing pretty well. I'm doing amazing because I got to do this today. I spent my whole day doing a takeover, which was super fun, and my family's from Baltimore, so at 8 we're gonna watch the Ravens game because the Ravens made it to the playoffs. So Hopefully there are no Bills fans in here, but yeah, we're hoping for a Ravens win.
I don't really pay attention to sports, so yay!
Yay, Ravens! You can
go
be...
Ravens!
Yeah.
Well, I play basketball. That's about the only sport I really, and baseball. Is the Ravens baseball or?
Ravens is football. Football. Yeah.
Because that would be really weird if I was like, I like baseball and basketball, and you were like, it is baseball.
No, yeah, my family, it's kind of weird because, well, it's not weird because my dad is really into sports, and my grandfather actually played in the NFL for the Baltimore Colts. Yeah, so we have, like, sports in our family, but all the kids in my family, like, in my immediate family, we're all just like, theater, woo! So my dad is, like, super sporty and everything, and, like, I would consider myself to be, like, pretty athletic. Like, I really like doing outdoor stuff and like hiking and biking and that sort of thing, but I don't play any more like organized sports. But yeah, it's kind of funny because there came a time where my dad was like, well, none of my kids are playing sports, you know, just gotta accept that.
Yeah, I'm actually the same way. I love doing outdoorsy stuff. I'm not as good. My brother and my dad, they're very sporty. I'm not very good at teams, like, you know, teams, like, knowing all the teams.
Yeah.
The Ravens was, you know. I'm from New Jersey, New York, so, of course, we're, like, you know, those teams. Those are about the only teams I know. my brother gets mad at me because, with blonde hair, do you accept to marry me?
I'm not an adult yet, and I want to go to college.
Yeah, all right. talking about sports, back to sports. So I did play softball for a very long time, and I played basketball for a very long time. I did voice lessons on top of all that. But then I stopped playing sports to do theater and acting, you know, professionally. Mm-hmm. Quote unquote professionally. So I think I love sports. I like to watch sports, but I never know who to root for.
Yeah, I know. It's like there are like teams, like we also like college football, and, you know, there are so many different teams. Like, it all depends, like, on where my grandparent, because my grandfather went to LSU. You know, in our family, we pretty much have our teams down straight, but I know, like, we have we know a family who, and like the Ravens and Steelers, if you know, are like huge rivals. We know a family where like the mom is like roots for the Steelers and the dad roots for the Ravens. So it's like funny. It's so funny. And yeah, we know a few families and friends that have that where it's like the family is split.
Yeah, I totally get it. My mom and my stepdad like the Yankees, and my dad is like the hugest Mets fan you will ever see. So, they're divorced, but that's not the reason. But that would be a really bad term. But yeah, so I don't, most of the time, I mean, I'm more into like the Mets just because I grew up with the Mets before my stepdad, you know, came to our family. So normally if like it was Mets versus Yankees, I would root for the Mets. But if it was the like Yankees versus someone else, I would root for the Yankees. So there's baseball. And it's kind of the same with, I guess, like, I don't really know, Yankees, Giants, and my dad likes the Jets. Yeah, so, rivals.
Oh, my God. Victoria and I turning 18 next year, we're going to be adults. Yes, we are going to be adults. That doesn't mean I'm ready to get married. So, I'm going to have to turn down your marriage proposal.
That was actually another guy, another person. But
yeah, I know that was another person, but yeah. I don't know how to pronounce your name. Sarah? Am I saying that right? Sarah?
I don't know.
Yeah, we're 18 adult twins.
I have two more years. Three and two-ish.
Oh my.
I might have to... I'm gonna... Okay. I hid him from the story, or I don't really know what I did. That was a little creepy. I might have to block him later, because I don't know him. Or
on the internet.
We don't need that right now.
I guess I appreciate that you like me, but not in that way.
Oh, you said it right. Okay, good. Yeah, that was a little creepy. Definitely don't need that right now.
Yeah, we have other things to worry about. I have college, I have acting, I have so many different things to worry about. What the heck? You are right, Nicole. What the heck?
Yes, and I'm going over because I love talking with you and I don't want to stop.
Do this again or FaceTime or something. Yes.
Yes, and we need to all do it. Like, Nicole, Victoria, We all need to, you know, get together.
Yes.
Not today, but sometime. Also, the person who wanted to marry you, normally you don't really marry someone that you just randomly saw online. You have to get to know the person first.
I'm all for, like, you know, you got to get to know someone inside. And I know, like, I've been on here and, you know, we've been having some cool talks, but we've just been talking about animals and baseball. I don't know if you know me that well enough to make, you know, like, judgment.
I'm going to assume that guy is not someone who should be on this live. And yes. I will definitely block him after this. Because obviously first of all, you haven't talked to him at all, or you don't know him. So, therefore, that's just, no.
No, it's crazy, like, especially for, like, young actors and models, there's so many weird people that, like, randomly reach out. I've been lucky to not get too many, but, like, every now and then I'll be added into, like, these group chats. It's so weird. And I have to, like, block everyone, but yeah. That's why, for young actors, they always have, like, parent monitored. Like, I'm old enough to be able to, like, take care of it myself, but yeah, like, or when I was younger, you know, my mom would be monitoring and stuff. And that's why, because of people like that.
Yeah, exactly. Like, if someone, when I was actually very little, there was someone who sent some, not gonna say what, but some bad pictures to me. I had to say I was, like, 11. I was young. I gave the phone right to my mom. I didn't even look at the picture. I didn't know who it was. It was an older man. No, not you, creep. The other creep.
Saro, you are part of the awesome adult club, you know. You and I, we could probably be friends, but yeah, no, not you. You are cool. It was the other dude. You are cool. You're
creep. So yeah, I mean, I'm gonna have to end this now, but I really don't want to.
I know. Yeah. We'll definitely later, though.
Sometime. Yes.
And I'll let you know how the Ravens did.
Yes, let me know, because I'm probably not gonna be watching it.
If you just see, like, a crying emoji, if I send you that, it'll probably be because they lost, but hopefully not, so.
Okay, hopefully I won't get a crying emoji later. But yeah, if you have any other questions for Victoria, make sure she's continuing She's continuing the takeover on my account, so make sure to ask her any questions if you still have any questions for her. If not, then great. Well, not great, but if not, then...
I mean, great. I mean, you do you. It's just like, you know, if you have a question to ask, if you don't, no worries.
Yeah. I definitely like to ask a bunch of questions. I normally, like, throw on a bunch of questions, and then...
Yeah, that was awesome. It was like, yeah, it was awesome. You and Nicole both, you guys sent some good questions. And my friend Netta also from acting class. So I have some really awesome friends, and I'm really grateful for all of you. Oh, hi, Sophia. She's so sweet.
Acting friends are the best. They will always have her back.
Yeah.
Not saying that I'm amazing, but
you are amazing.
Thank you. But every acting friend that I've met, it's just amazing because we share the same interests.
Yeah. And
we can all be, it's just, we connect way easier than, I mean, I have other friends too, but, like, there's just some similarities that, like, you can't do with, like, your normal friends. Not normal friends, but other friends.
Yeah, I don't understand it, you, the same way, like, as an artist and as a, that sort of part of you. I think your acting friends understand the best.
Yeah, definitely.
Someone has a question. Okay.
If you have a question, I have to end it now. I'm really sorry. But if you have a question, make sure, put it on the takeover. She will answer them on the takeover. But if you guys want to donate, the link is in my bio for JDRF_cabaret and also carly_alexa. I'm sure you can actually answer that quickly. How many siblings do you have?
I have, oh my God, why do I have to think about that so much? I have 3 siblings. I'm a triplet. I have a brother and sister as my triplet siblings, and then I have an older brother.
That's so cool. I didn't know you were a triplet.
Sometimes I forget, like, it's such a, like, a normal part of my life. I always forget to, like, I don't know, say it, I guess, mention it. Yeah.
Really cool. I'm really sad that I have to end this, but I do. But yeah, if you want to donate, as I said before, the link is in my bio, and, Victoria is going to continue the takeover on my account, JDRF_cabaret. So make sure to stay tuned for that. And I hope you have the good rest of your day, everyone, and Victoria. Thank you so much for joining me today, Victoria. It was so much fun.
Thank you for having me. Oh my gosh. And I'm definitely planning on donating. I have to, you know, check in with my mom and stuff, but yes, I will definitely do that because I really love everything you're doing. And I think it's amazing.
Thank you so much. And it's totally fine if you can't. I totally understand. A dollar is great. Like I always say, every penny counts. But I totally get it if you can't. I completely understand. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining. Once again, thank you, Victoria. Bye, everyone.
Bye.